Next to the Amazon River, there's actually a second gigantic hydrographic system, with the Paraná and Uruguay River draining one-fifth of the remaining South American continent. But about 280 kilometers before these rivers discharge into the ocean, the riverbanks suddenly widen into an enormous horn before the waters finally flow into the Atlantic Ocean. This funnel-shaped indent into the South American coastline is called the Río de la Plata, and it looks very different to pretty much any other river's delta. So what actually happened here? It all started with a wide geological fault that formed during the breakup of Gondwana, which gave the structural framework for the notch in the continental shelf. As tectonic activity further shaped the land of South America, much of the continent's runoff was eventually redirected into this originally 2 kilometer deep depression, and millions of tons of loose sediments from the rivers then slowly got deposited within. By now, the incoming sediments from the rivers and tidal forces from the Atlantic Ocean have found an equilibrium, giving the Río de la Plata a gentle gradient from 2 to a 20 meter depth at the transition with the Atlantic Ocean. Throughout these 280 kilometers, the Río de la Plata is separated into various zones with completely different habitats along the way. At the mouth of the rivers, low salinity levels of around 2 PSU create a freshwater habitat, which slowly transitions to the mixed zones of brackish water, where a distinct vertical salinity gradient rises from the seafloor to the water surface, and sediments are still heavily suspended in the water, creating the characteristic orange and brown tints. After passing the Uruguayan capital of Montevideo, the water depth drops to its deepest level, the funnel opens up to its maximum width, and the tidal push raises the salinity level to over 10 times the level that is measured in Buenos Aires. Considering all of these characteristics, the Río de la Plata is actually quite the puzzle to the scientific community, which tries to make it fit in with one of the standardized classifications of hydrography. The most straightforward would be calling it a river, as the name suggests, with the Spanish and Portuguese word rio meaning river in English. Looking at the overall geometry and proportions, however, it doesn't really align with what we usually call a river, though. Alternatives are the terms bay, which is defined as a broad inlet of the sea where the land curves inwards, a marginal sea, which is a semi-enclosed body of water adjacent to and widely open to the ocean, or an estuary, which is that area of a river mouth which is affected by sea tides. While every definition has some fitting aspects to it, the debate probably won't be settled anytime soon, but my personal favorite would be the estuary, since the brackish zone is such a defining characteristic of the Río de la Plata. If you want to learn more about the hydrography of our planet, I have a whole playlist covering the longest rivers right here, or watch what YouTube thinks is best for you here. See you in the next one. Cheers.